Hi, Noora.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm great.
I've just taken up jogging. Actually, yeah. Maybe I should say sprinting. I've just run up and down three or four times. Whew. But do you know what that meant? I got to catch your show. You could have made an effort to dress up, though. Come on.
What?
Look at this. That is fantastic. I'm loving your horns.
Thank you.
They look great too. And you did a great show. You sounded spot on. And you are, you're just getting bigger and bigger and bigger.
Thank you so
much. I'm so happy for you. It sounds great. I saw you. Actually, we were just talking about it. I was just talking to Delaine. And I saw you with them. And I think it was Sabaton.
Yeah.
In London. So that was maybe 4 years ago. Yeah. 4 or 5.
Yeah.
Now look at you. You've just grown and grown and grown.
Yeah. It's great. It's great. And this was one of the best experiences for now. So.
Yeah. And you know what? I have to say personally. Personally to you. I think your voice has even got... You have a fantastic voice. But today, it's like double. It's so much better.
Yeah,
well,
that's
sorry,
really
not better.
Nice.
It's improved.
Yeah,
it's
but you know, it's really
further.
Nice to hear that I can do improvement because as an artist and musician, you always want to go forward and develop yourself. So if they would be like, yeah, you're still as good as 7 years ago, it would be like, ah. But now it's like, yes, that's really nice to hear. And many people have told me that, like, what have you done to that you... You sound different than before, but it's, you know, I've started to use more courage what I want to do in Battle Beast as a singer, and kind of there is not just one way to do it, but you can actually use so many different sounds. That was the whole idea when the first time I came to this band, but of course during these years it's been developing and I've been doing, at the same time as I'm in Battle Beast, I'm still doing different stuff as a singer.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and like in different genres. So it's really important to people who wants to learn how to sing like in various ways. And if you just want to do metal, you should still try different things because it will widen up your perspective and as a singer and as an artist and how you want to tell the story to people. So I really recommend to do different kind of stuff and push yourself out of your limits, out of your comfort zone.
Absolutely. Even if it's not something you're going to be doing, it still helps you find maybe just a little thing.
Yeah.
Like maybe like a little flick, a little curl.
Yeah.
Amazing. Oh, wow. That's really cool. So what else are you doing?
Well, actually, I'm giving vocal coaching and in performance too. So I have this concept called Sing Like a Beast. And I have, like, I take applications in by taking mail applications from people. And now it's been really good. Like, there are a lot of students that I have right now and a lot of coming up. So I'm feeling like, okay, now I need to maybe start... maybe I should... start planning some kind of tour for that, you know, to reach more people because there are just one me to give to give the lessons as so many people who want to learn how to sing in heavy metal style and rock style. So
are you doing that online or just in your home city?
I do it by Skype and also live, and I have also international students and in the future, there's going to be a YouTube channel, like my own YouTube channel, where for Sing Like a Beast, and I'm giving some tips there. And of course, I just want to, you know, share all the knowledge that I have as an artist and musician to other people, because I think it's just, you know, a legacy that you should just put forward and not just keep it to yourself if you are able to. You know, teach people how to do certain stuff.
Because also, you're not going to be around forever.
You
need to pass the torch.
Yeah. That's right.
Okay, so what have you learned recently then with your vocals to something you've learned new to do?
What I've learned? Well, I've learned to trust my my softer side.
Oh, okay.
Because that was a long... kind of in time it has been a challenge for me to trust that it's not only the rough and screaming stuff that I do that people like, but they actually like the softer side of me too. So what I've been doing with the previous two albums we've had, I've shown that I've kind of put myself there naked,
yeah,
kind of, and wanted to see if people like that kind of softer sound that I have, and it's been good, and I'm very happy because that helps me to kind of develop my like confidence as a vocalist, that okay, I can do even more stuff and in so many different ways and with different sounds.
Yeah, it was that sort of obviously confidence just in yourself, but also was it quite a brave step to kind of open up with the softer side as well?
Yeah, because you know, when I started to learn how to use raspy sound, that was 10 years ago actually, when I got to know Janis Joplin's music. Oh, yeah. And she's my biggest idol ever, and she is the reason why I have the rasp in my voice nowadays. So when I started, I just, you know, of course I got carried away and so excited about that I can make this big raspy sound. So I did it almost too much, and then my own vocal mentor taught me how to kind of push the brake for the, right. you know, so
toned it down a bit.
Yeah.
Okay. Nice. Okay. So, what about the band? What's the latest album? I'm behind. I was working in a shitty job and I've missed everything.
Well, No More Hollywood Endings has been the most successful for us for now, and it's been so great to see that people have taken it so well, and it's been also great to see how much it's been causing a kind of, some people are like, what the fuck is this? This is bullshit. This is not heavy metal. And I'm so happy about that because, you know, and then there are people like, yes, finally something new, something fresh, something, you know, this is the thing that people say that I have, you know, big balls, like mentally and in my voice. But it's also, I think it's the kind of mentality in our band that we want to try things and we want to do anyways really good music and see how people react to that. And you know what I've been saying to some of my closest people, that yeah, there has been already done, you know, the best 80s music there is for in heavy metal, and we don't want to be kind of, you know, doing the same thing, but we will use some of the influences that we get there from there and other bands too and artists. So it's like, it's been great to see how strong emotions we have have pulled up from with the latest album especially, and we want to keep surprising people and making our show more theatrical and music more theatrical, and that is my vision and dream for our band, that we can make this kind of, it's not just music, but it's an experience. When you come to our show, there is so much stuff that you can see, and we also want to keep the humor in our show, because that is one of the main things about our band too, that we want to have fun, we want to show people that heavy metal is not just, you know, grumpy faces and horns, but it's also, you know, that you can just take off the lift of your shoulders, forget everyday life, and just jump into the battle beast world for a while to have fun with heavy metal.
Absolutely. So what can you see your show being in, say, 10 years time?
Well, of course we have huge ambitions, and we want to of course reach more and more people all the time, and whenever people ask what is our goal, that is world domination. So that is our goal, and in 10 years I hope we are you know, having even more and more people supporting us and we can do shows even bigger than they are right now, because of course that means that too, that we can make our shows bigger in visually too, and that is my dream, that we can kind of share even more bigger experiences with our audience.
More beastiness. So lights and pyros kind of a given. Are we talking like stage performers, some stilt walkers, fire breathers, grinders?
There is going to be a lot of things to see in the future. Yeah.
I can almost imagine it a bit like Moulin Rouge.
Yeah.
But equal, you know, guys and girls.
Yeah, of course. Well, we'll see what happens.
Okay, so you're not going to give anything
no.
up?
No, of
that's
course.
That's what I'm after here.
It's a, you know, professional secret I can't share.
Ah, right, of course. Right, well, I've held you up enough. I shall let you finish your day. Relax.
Thank you so much.
Great to see you again. I've just remembered last time we spoke, we literally finished when you had to go on stage. Can you remember that?
No.
Oh, okay, fine.
It's been too long, you know. I just told my friends that I don't even remember what happened a year ago.
Yeah.
Just basic stuff, like the, okay, we did an album and there was some tours and, you know, but it's like everything else is fuzzy. Like fuzzy.
Do you keep a diary?
I should.
Is that Instagram?
That's a good idea.
A bit late now.
Yeah, yeah. Like, okay, maybe I should start now.
Or does Instagram count as that?
Yeah,
days?
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe.
That's right.
Cool. Great to see you again.
Okay,
hope we'll see you in UK soon.
Actually, yes. We have the second European tour leg coming first to United Kingdom. We start at 15th of November.
November, okay.
Yeah, so go get your tickets.
All right. Thank you.
All right. Thank you.